Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Mili from Erudite Chemistry classes and today I'm taking a very important topic and this is developments leading to the quantum mechanical model of atom. This is the latest one. Although we have learned Bohr's model of atom which was given by the Niels Bohr in 1913. But what was the problem in that? We all know that this Bohr's model of atom could not explain the splitting of the line, spectral line, in the electric field as well as in the magnetic field. And this splitting of a spectral line in the magnetic field is called Zeeman effect, and the splitting of a spectral line in the electric field was called Stark effect. So I can say that it could not explain the Stark and Zeeman effect. Second flaw was, it completely considers that the electron is a particle. Although now it was like getting proof that electrons, just like the light, electrons also have the wave nature. So what were the two major concepts which leads us to the new development of the model, and they ignored the model which was given by the Bohr? That is, we are now going to consider this new model, and this new model considers what? It does not consider the electron as a particle. It considers that the electron is also having two nature, that is wave nature and particle nature. So first of all, I'm talking about the de Broglie concept of the dual nature of the particle. It was given in 1924 by the de Broglie, and it brings the thing in our mind that every particle, what he suggested, that every particle, whether it is microscopic or it is macroscopic, every particle consists of dual behavior. Now what does dual behavior means? Dual means both behaviors, both, like it can behave like a wave as well as it can behave like a particle. So if I consider the particle nature of the electron, I can write E equals mc square. I can give this relation with its mass and the energy of the particle according to Einstein equation. When I am considering that the particle is there, so it is showing the particle nature. If I consider that the electron or any of the particle is having that wavy nature, then what? Then this energy can be calculated as E equals to h nu. When we are considering that it is a wave, okay? So it behaves like wave. And just because we know that a single substance is containing both the qualities, that is like a matter, it is behaving like a particle. So I am keeping both these equations equal. So what will happen then? H nu equals mc square, and h nu can be written as nu is c upon lambda, so it is equal to mc square. I am just cancelling it out and I get h 1 upon nu equals mc, or I can write it as n lambda equals h upon mc. And just because we are talking about, de Broglie was talking about the particles, he is not talking about the light. So here this c, that is the speed of the light, can be replaced by the velocity of that particle jiski hum baat kar rahe hain. So can I replace it with the v? So if I am replacing it with the v, I am getting mv. And we know that momentum of a particle can be calculated as p equals to mv. So I am replacing it h upon p. So this gives us the formula to calculate the relation between the lambda of the particles and the mass of the particle. So every particle, according to de Broglie, every particle should consist of wave nature and particle nature. As well, we can relate it to the mass of the particle and the lambda. If we go through this equation, if we look at this equation, we will come to know that the lambda of the particle is inversely proportional to the mass of that particle. What does it mean? It means that if the mass of the particle is big, okay, then the lambda will be lesser. Okay, so if this is more, this will be very less. If this is very less, this will be more. So in the case of every small particle like electrons, they are very small and the mass is very small. In case of the microscopic particles like electrons, the mass is very, very small. That is why the wavelength, that is a lambda associated with it, will be very large. And just because it is very large, we cannot assume any of this very small particle without considering its wavelength. We cannot ignore its wavelength. On the other hand side, if the mass is very high, obviously the lambda will become very low. That is what he said, that every substance has its own lambda, and this lambda can be calculated by using the formula lambda equals to h upon mv, and this lambda is called de Broglie wavelength, and this equation is known as de Broglie equation. And not only this, de Broglie has given this equation. Meanwhile, one scientist was there, that is Germer and Davison. So Davison and Germer, these two scientists, Germer and Davison, these two scientists, these were also working on the same pattern, that is they were trying to find out ki electrons are wave or they are the particles. They have performed an experiment which is called electron beam diffraction experiment. Electron beam ka diffraction pattern they observed, and they say that just like the wave nature of the light, इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑल्सो शो द डिफ्रैक्शन पैटर्न. जबकि डिफ्रैक्शन पैटर्न कौन शो करता है? वेव करती है. तो हम तो पार्टिकल मान के चल रहे हैं, तो बिल्कुल सही है ये कहना किसका? डी ब्रोगली का, कि इलेक्ट्रॉन जो है वो पार्टिकल ही नहीं है, दे आर ऑल्सो शोइंग द वेव नेचर. सो इट वॉज प्रैक्टिकली proved by the Davison and German by his experiment, in which he shows that the electron also show the diffraction pattern just like the wave. Okay, on the other hand side, we can talk about another very important concept, and that is Hintzberg uncertainty principle. Hintzberg said that it is practically impossible to measure the location and the velocity of the electron at that particular time. That is, you cannot measure both the things together simultaneously. If you try to pick the electron, to locate the electron, you will definitely do some error in locating, yeah, in assessing its velocity. So if we talk about the location of the electron and we talk about the momentum of the electron at that particular place, so what will happen? The uncertainty in your calculation will be there. That is, uncertainty we are showing by delta, that is the difference which you are, the value which you assessed and the value which is actual value. The uncertainty in the position and the uncertainty in the momentum, and momentum of the particle is delta p, or I can say is that momentum is delta m into v. But just because the delta m is not changing here, because we are talking about the electron, so hum ise kya likh sakte hain? Delta m ki jagah I can write down m into delta v. So the uncertainty in the position and uncertainty in the velocity at that particular position will be either more or equal to h upon 4 pi. You cannot assess the position as well as the velocity of that particle at that particular instance. उस समय पर, इस जगह पर, इस इलेक्ट्रॉन की वेलोसिटी कितनी है, that you cannot find out. The reason is that if we want to know where is the electron, we have to use a light, या we have to use some radiation to locate it. अब अगर हम रेडिएशन डाल रहे हैं, big lambda radiation will not work. क्यों? क्योंकि इलेक्ट्रॉन is a very small particle. अब क्या करना है हमको? वी नीड टू हैव अ रेडिएशन विच शुड हैव वेरी लेस लैम्डा. अगर हम लेस लैम्डा की रेडिएशन यूज करते हैं, तो लैम्डा इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू 1/e. वी नो दैट द एनर्जी विल इंक्रीज, लैम्डा विल डिक्रीज. द लैम्डा विल इंक्रीज, एनर्जी विल डिक्रीज. तो अगर हमारा लैम्डा इज वेरी लेस, द एनर्जी विल बी वेरी हाई. अब क्योंकि एनर्जी बढ़ गई, आपने उसको लोकेट किया, यू गेट दिस लोकेशन, यस दिस इज द पोजीशन, यू हैव मेंशन द पोजीशन, बट जस्ट बिकॉज यू कोलाइडेड इट एट दैट पर्टिकुलर इंस्टेंस, द इलेक्ट्रॉन विल चेंज इट्स स्पीड. बिकॉज ऑफ द कोलिजन द एनर्जी विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड. ओके, एंड एनर्जी विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड मीन्स इट विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू द काइनेटिक एनर्जी. द एनर्जी कंटेंट विल चेंज, द वेलोसिटी विल बी चेंज, एंड दैट इज व्हाई इफ यू आर कैचिंग इट एट अ पर्टिकुलर पोजिशन, द पोजिशन विल बी करेक्ट, बट द अनदर पार्ट, दैट इज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ दैट पार्टिकल, यू विल बी अनसर्टेन. तो ओवरऑल वी कैन से दैट अनसर्टेनिटी इन द पोजिशन एंड द अनसर्टेनिटी इन द वेलोसिटी ऑफ दैट पार्टिकल विल बी ईदर मोर और इट इज इक्वल टू द एच अपॉन 4 pi. That is called Hinsberg uncertainty principle. तो इसका मतलब क्या हुआ कि हिंसबर्ग अनसर्टेनिटी प्रिंसिपल आते ही ये बात बिल्कुल कैंसिल हो जाती है कि यू कैन हैव द डेफिनेट पाथ फॉर द इलेक्ट्रॉन बट यू कैन रिप्लेस दिस स्टेटमेंट दैट डेफिनेट पाथ आर नॉट देयर यू कैन जस्ट प्रिडिक्ट दे शुड बी द इलेक्ट्रॉन शुड बी हियर और हियर और हियर सो रादर देन स्पीकिंग अबाउट द डेफिनेट पाथ or rather you can speak about the definite location you can say the probability to find the electron in an atom in a particular area so you can give the reason where the electron can found but you cannot locate them here here or here so just observe one more thing here that if I am writing down delta x into m I am removing I am taking to this side that is delta x into delta v uncertainty in the position uncertainty in the velocity is either more or equal to h upon 4 pi. I'm taking this m to this side m. Can you understand one thing? If my particle is bigger, it is heavier, the mass is more and obviously the mass is more means the uncertainty will be lesser. That is why we can ignore the uncertainty. We will become more and more certain jitna zyada hamara mass होता जाएगा बट जस्ट बिकॉज क्योंकि हमारा इलेक्ट्रॉन बहुत ही छोटा है हम इसके मास को कम रखेंगे तो अनसर्टेनिटी काफी ज्यादा हो जाएगी एंड दैट इज वाई यू कैन नॉट इवन से कि ये रहा इलेक्ट्रॉन और इसकी स्पीड इतनी है व्हाट यू कैन से द प्रोबेबिलिटी टू फाइंड द इलेक्ट्रॉन इज दिस इज द एरिया जहां पे इलेक्ट्रॉन मिल सकते हैं सो वी हैव टू मेक मेनी चेंजेस इन बोर्स मॉडल ऑफ एटम बिकॉज इट इग्नोर्स द वेवी नेचर ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन So, we have to go for the new model of atom which should consider the wave nature as well as the particle nature. So, now we need a model which should consider the wave nature and the particle nature of the electron. That is the dual nature of the electron. And our new model that is quantum mechanical model of atom. It is totally based on the concept that our electron is dual, is belonging to the dual characteristic. Dual behavior of electron. So, in another video, we'll talk about quantum mechanical model of atom, which considers both the nature of the particle, that is the dual nature of the particle, wave nature and particle nature. Okay, thank you.